So hello friends, welcome again to my YouTube channel. Today the problem that we are going to discuss is number complement. It's problem number 476. Let's go through the problem description first. So given a positive integer output, its complement number, and the complement strategy is to flip the bits of its binary representation. Let's look into the example. So input is 5 and the output should be 2. How 2 is the output? So we all know the binary representation of 5 is 101, and when we do its complement, so this 1 becomes 0, this 0 becomes 1, and this 1 becomes 0. So the decimal representation of 010 is 2, right? So our output should be 2. Let's jump to the blackboard to understand it. So here you can see what we have to achieve is this thing. We have to flip every bit of the number. So here when we see the number is 5 and its binary representation is 101, when we flip each bit it becomes 2, right? Now there are a number of ways to achieve this, to solve this problem, but I will cover one of the technique, which is bit masking. So I will be covering bit masking concept in this video. So what is bit masking? If you know the XOR concept, so when we do one XOR of 1, it will give us 0. When we do 0 XOR of 0, it will also give 0. And when we do an XOR of 0, it will give 1, and 0 XOR of 1 will give us 1. Now if we see this first case and the last case, so here we can see with the help of 1 XOR 1, this 1 is flipped to 0. Right, so here flip is happening, and similarly we see here 0 XOR 1, 0 is flipped to 1, right? So here basically flip is happening with the help of XORing with 1, right? So in both the cases, if we see when we are XORing with 1, we get the flip bit. However, if we do XOR with 0, the bit is not changing, right? So what we get an idea from here is when we see 101, and when we take a mask of 111, so this 1 and 1 XOR will become 0, 0 and 1 XOR will be 1 only, and 1 and 1 XOR will be 0. So we got this, right? And this is basically 2, right? So this is our mask, right? So with the help of this mask, we are able to achieve our solution. All right, so our main task is to find this mask value. Now we will see how we can find this mask. So if we see 111 is basically 7, right, in decimal format, and 7 is 2 raised to power 3 minus 1, right? So there are how many number of bits are there? 3. So that's why this 3 comes from, And when we do 2 raised to power number of bits minus 1, we will get our mask, right, which is 111. Right, and so our first task is to find the number of bits, then we can find the mask using 2 raised to power number of bits minus 1, right? And this we can easily achieve using math.pow to the 2 raised to power power, right? Or we can also do we can also use 1 left shift the number of bits. So here number of bits is 3 and we do minus 1, so that will also give 7, right? So now our task, now we have to see how we can find the number of bits. So our original number is 101, right? And when we do this right shift first time, it will become 010, right? So what left shift will do, what right shift will do, this will goes to the right, this will come here, this will come here, and here will be 10, so 0 will come here, right? So first time when we do right shift, it will become 010. Second time it will be 001, and at last it will become 000, right? So here we will do counter, which will be counter 1 plus 1, here will be plus 1, and here will be plus 1. So our count of bits will be 3 ultimately. So let's see how we can solve it using from the code. So first we will quickly write one method which will give us the number of bits, right? Int, it will return int get number of bits, and it will accept the number, right? And it would finally return the count, which is initially 0, and while our num is not equals to 0, right? So we are seeing this condition, and our num will be num right shift 1, right? Now we'll do count plus plus, and at last we'll return our count, which will be the number of bits, and here we will be having 1 int num of bits, which will be this one, and we'll be having 1 mask, which will be 1 left shift of num of bits minus 1, and finally we will be going to return the XOR of num and our mask, right? Try to run this code. So this method, let's try to submit this code. So what I was saying, this method we can use to find the number of bits, and yeah, you can see this code is successfully submitted. So yeah friends, that's it for today. I will be providing the problem and solution link into the description, and I hope you like this concept of bit programming. It will give you like basics of bit manipulations. So thanks friends.